Hello everybody, welcome back to Breath of the Wild. I am back here in the Goron City to talk to this Gerudo who has a quest. Daytime sure is hot. Yes, it is. Do you have some amber? Mm-hmm. 10 amber. I'm pretty sure I have 10 amber. Yes. Sell them to the shop, you get 300 rupees, or give them to me for 500 rupees. A piece? Because I'm pretty sure it's 500... No, it'd be 300 a piece. Sure. It's a huge help. Thanks. 500... Wait. Bring me 10 at a time, okay? As for what kind of jewels I want to buy, well, that's likely to change every once in a while. Okay. So, let me... Okay, go back. Inventory. Amber. There you are. Okay, that makes sense. Yeah. It's like 30 rupees, that makes sense. Alright, you. 10 diamonds. I don't have 10 diamonds. Okay, well that was that quest. One of those. Okay, next on the list is there is a hidden memory, or a unlockable memory thing here. So, I am going to run out there, and we're going to unlock a memory. So I'll see you over there. Shrine nearby. Is there a shrine in the middle of this lake here? Sure seems like it. Well, if that's the case, I guess we're doing a shrine first. Yep. Definitely looks like it. Yep. There it is. Qual Raym Shrine. Well, down we go. A balanced approach. Oh boy, we get to play with, well, yeah. There's a name for these things. I cannot, for the life of me, think about what it is right now. Oh, stop time. That's not what I want. I want Magnesis. Alright, so there's a key I need. No, I don't want to be crouching like this. Immediately, I am stumped. That's not a good sign for, well, either this puzzle or my mental health or mental fortitude. Neither of which is good. Can I hit that with a bow? Nope. Give me my arrow back. Oh, you know what? I need to fire arrows through these things. Is that gonna hit it? No, it's not. Whoosh. No. Oh, there it goes. There it catches fire. I was gonna say, is it not gonna catch fire? Awesome. I'm thinking I may not have wanted to do that side, though. Chest? If it's a key, I can work with this. Small key. Yes, it is. Sweet. Alright. I want to burn those barrels, but I'm not going to, because if I do, I'll end up needing them. Alright. Magnesis. Come on. Oh, come on. Really? Alright. So I want to move, actually, first... Drop that there. Bomb. Pull out, place. Now back to Magnesis. Put that down there. Back to bomb, blow that up. So, that is that part of the puzzle, but I want to get that chest over there. So, the question now becomes, how do I do that? Whoa, almost too close. Well, those... Yeah. Okay. Now, question is, can I jump on top of that? Actually. Oh, come on, really? Alright, drop that there. Jump. Okay, really? Alright, there we go. And jump over to here. Alright, throw. Maybe not throw, but. I can't tell if it's actually getting up on there or not. Oh, come on! It knocked me off! What's that shit? Okay. So let's go there. Grab on, thank you. Alright. Oh. Shoot, okay. Alright, well, that's how you do that. Well, that's a way to do that. Knight's Claymore, next to useless. I think I have some Korok leaves. Oh, I forgot to mention. Yeah, a bunch of Korok leaves. So, I was doing my mid-episode exploring thing, and I found a, I was going to this shrine and then saw an island over here, so I went to this island. And basically what it did was it took away all of my items and took away all my items, and I had to take 3 orbs to 3 different platform things and activate them all with nothing. And there was the big one-eyed guy, I cannot think for the life of me what they're called. That was the biggest pain in the butt. Because he had an orb around his neck, and it was all a pain. But I went out there and did that, and so I needed a bunch of Korok leaves. There, okay. Before that kills me. Sweet. Anyway, so I did that between episodes, and explored and found some other things you might have seen on the map there, but unlocked a few things, which hopefully we'll get to eventually, probably in the next episode or two, because I want to finish up all the areas I'm in now, so. All right. Now I gotta figure out how to get over there without dying in lava. Probably just climb up here. So yeah, I found a shrine over here that I unlocked only as far as to be able to fast travel to it. Let's see, there's a guy here that has a quest. There's a guy here that has a quest. It's actually the same guy, so I'm gonna go to those two. And then, do this one as well. So we got 2 shrines, 2 quests, and this memory to unlock. So that's the plan for the next episode or two. I still haven't done the live stream. Hopefully I'm doing that tomorrow as I'm recording this. I'm recording this on a Saturday. Saturday night. So hopefully Sunday I will be doing a live stream. And hopefully that'll be of this area over here. Or maybe this area over here. I haven't decided which. I want to do the area on the right, just so I can finish the right side of the map, but I also want to be making progress towards the other divine beasts. But I haven't decided which way it is that I want to go yet. I am going in the wrong direction. So I'll meet you all over by the memory, and then we'll figure out where we go from there. Alright, so here we are. There's a Korok here. And here is our memory. So let's watch what this one is. Whoa.
My cut doesn't look too bad, actually. You're fine for now. But you know, there's a fine line between courage and recklessness. As brave as you are, that does not make you immortal.
Wow.
It seems that not only is the frequency of these types of attacks on the rise, but the scale of beasts we are facing is intensifying as well. I fear that this is an omen which portends the return of Calamity Ganon. And if that's the case, I'm ready to expect the worst. We'll need to make preparations as soon as possible.
Interesting. I still don't like that Zelda has a British accent. It just doesn't fit for me. It's just completely wrong somehow. Okay. That is done. And I think that probably means we're done with Elden Mountain. So I don't have to be wearing, my heat resistant stuff anymore. At least not so permanently. So, now, let's go do this quest here. Oh, there he is. You can see him right there on the rock. Oh, I didn't realize. Okay, this is apparently going to be a shrine quest. Crown of Bone. What do you have for me? Didn't think anyone was around. You didn't see me fall in from the sky behind you? I know a song about this place. Would you like to hear the ancient verse? Yes. Mount the beast upon its throne. The lush green could refer to this place, but what sort of beast wears a crown of bone? It's definitely a secret meaning. A crown of bone. Huh. A crown of bone. A beast that wears a crown of bone. What wears a crown of bone? And more importantly, what wears a crown of bone in the context of Zelda? I'm thinking some kind of skeletal horse? Skeletal something. But where would you get a skeletal horse? I know one exists in the game. Come here. You have a head of bone. Boom! Explosion. Oh. Restless cricket. I'll take that. Horn. Bokoblin arm. Man, this one, I have no idea what this... Oh, hey, ice dragon person. That's cool. I really don't know. Well, that wasn't it. A beast with a crown of bone. I have no idea what that means. This might be a quest that I come pick up later, or look up and do later. You! Raym's a crown of bone. It's not exactly bone, but... But could that work? If it would stop running, that would be nice. Where is it run? Okay, well, it just disappeared. Could it be a goat? Or a bull? I mean, it's technically not bone. The horns technically aren't bones. But it's bony. Anything up here, I wonder? I hear a Korok, though. Oh, I already found him. Okay. A crown of bone. I feel like it's gotta be a ram or a bull or something. But I don't know where I'd find a ram or a bull. If it's not in this area, I think I'm gonna... Can I mount a deer? Nah, neither of them have horns. They're not male. That guy is male. Gotta sneak up real... Well, or not. Okay, yeah, I'm not gonna be catching that guy. Well, I'm not thinking there's gonna be one around here, so I'm gonna take a rain check on that. So I'm gonna go to Hateno Village and, show this kid the fire rod and subsequently the Moblin Club, because that'll be the next thing he asks for. Because I did some scouting ahead on that quest on a different profile, so... Alright, I'm going to change this stamp to that for... I'm using that as the thing. Or as shrines, so Hateno Village. And of course it's raining. Why wouldn't it be raining? Quit. Tracking the quest would help. Adventure log. Oh, ceremonial song. I know how to do that one too, so we'll need to go do that as well. The weapon connoisseur. Looks like he's in his home. Hope I can show it while he's in his home. I would imagine I'd be able to. Neb, you. Yes, I got you a fire rod. Here you go. Wow, exactly like the books. 20 rupees. Woo! Give it to who teaches you to fight. Well, that's not it. What was that? Yes, that one. A Moblin Club. Alright, so I should point out, I got the fire rod. There was a Poe that had it by the Woodland Tower. So that's where I got that. Next, the Moblin Club. And since I'm on the map, I got it in the forested area around here. There were a bunch of, moblins that were sitting there sleeping, so that's where I got them. Okay, now I want to equip it. Whoops, nope. Talk. Yes, I got you a Moblin Club. Go ahead and look at it. A big ol' two-handed weapon. Even more amazing than I'd imagined, just like in the books again. Another thank you, 50 rupees. I got it from Grandpa, so think of it as a thank you from him. Next, it is a duplex bow. Apparently, you get that from Yiga clan members, which I haven't actually seen yet in this playthrough, but I know exist. So, that's the weapon connoisseur, as far as I can go there. Let's see. So next, the ceremonial song. And that is in Zora's domain. If you recall before, I couldn't find the weapon I needed, but I now know where that is. So, the sword I need is right... I think it's right around here somewhere. So let's go out into the water. Let's see, I should be able to see with magnesis. Okay, I have magnesis. Okay, Magnesis. There it is, right there. Alright, so I want to use my freezing stuff. Get out there. Let's see, Magnesis. There it is. And I'm not close enough. Let's see. Let me make sure I have okay, I have weapon slots. I want my freezing ability. This should make me close enough. Magnesis. There we go. Alright. Whoop, nope. Up here. Ceremonial trident. Woohoo! Okay, now I gotta make my way back up and to the shrine. Or at least the spot that I need to do the thing with the ceremonial thing. I don't need this shit anymore. I don't need the fire rod either. So drop. I also killed a Lynel. It took a whole bunch of food and a whole bunch of time, but I did it. So yeah, that was a thing. So yeah, back up here to do the thing. Alright, so we're here. This is the thing. And what I gotta do is swim up the waterfall. Whoosh. And fall just so. Alright. B, Y. Nope. Hey, that worked. Or not. Okay, well, let's do it again, and this time do it right. I guess I have to hit Y to do the downward spike thing from using this. Like that, except I missed. God damn it, I did this the first time on the other profile. I did it just so I could practice it, but I did that first go, and now it's taking me forever to do this one. Alright, and why am I going backwards? Why am I going backwards? One, the wind is forcing me towards the waterfall, and two, that's not how physics works. This works. There we go. It should have worked the first time, damn it. Whatever. It's open now. That's all that matters. I think there's 300 rupees in this one. It's, again, since it's a quest one, the trial is essentially the quest itself. The quest to uncover it is the trial. Alright. Dagah Keek Shrine. Alright. Dagah Keek Shrine. What do you have for me? Silver rupee, 100 rupees. Okay, not as much as I thought. But still not bad. Give me a spirit orb, please. I will then need two more. Bling! Let's get the hell out of here. Oh, I have three. Didn't realize. Alright, so now that that's taken care of, we're going to go to Rucco Maag Shrine. And do that. And here we are. There's a bunch of spikes making a path through here. It's very simple, actually. It's just this. Let's go to the side here, and it's just a straight path. So, inside we go. See what it has for us. This is five flames. Interesting. What the hell are these things? Oh, this is not gonna be good. Okay. I have to light the five lights, right? Ooh. No, let's keep that. I wanna go fire arrow. Oh, there goes that bow. Give me this chest, which I could have used magnesis on. Figures. Opal, nothing really all that great. Let's see. I need a bow again. Soldier's bow. That should burn that up. Yes. Alright. Oh, okay. I see. I was too busy looking in the background and seeing the puzzle thing that I didn't see what I got there. Doesn't look like it was a weapon or a shield. Whatever. Okay, well, that didn't work. Oh, okay. Now I want it. Okay. That's the active one. That's not it. Oh, the arm broke. Awesome. Okay, that doesn't work. This is inconsistent. Oh, okay. Arrows? I want it to go... Yeah, like that. Let's go to a normal arrow. There. Okay. And then I want it to go this way. So the water is doing that. Okay. I want it to go... I don't know. I want it to go the opposite of this direction. You know what? Actually... okay, go... No, that's not what I wanted to do. Anyway, I want to hit that one. See if I can freeze it. No. Okay. Okay, this is strange. Can I use a fire arrow on it? Can I light them that way? Is that cheating? I think... Hey, that worked! Okay, and if this works, that is just cheesing it to I don't know what degree, but stop trying to run up the lamppost, God. Alright. Do I have to hit it in the right spot for it to actually light it that way? Looks like it. One, two, three, four, five. Yep, that was it. That was far easier with arrows than it was trying to, you know. It's actually probably impossible to do it with just these things. Let me get this arrow back. So I need all the... I don't need the arrows. It's just nice to have a bunch of arrows. So if I don't... it's best not to waste them if I don't have to. Give me my fourth orb! There we go. That's four. Sweet. Okay. So now I'm going to head over to this stamp, which is yet another quest, another shrine quest from the same bird guy. I forget what his name is, but either way, we're going over there. And yeah, I guess I'll just see you over there. There's really nothing between here and there. Alright, buddy. What do I have to do for this one, I wonder? Probably some wind puzzle based on what he's saying there. Sure, I'd be alone, remote place. Pardon me for not greeting you sooner. Well, I kind of came up behind you, so I wouldn't be surprised. I know a song about this place. Would you like to hear the ancient verse? Yes. The rocks serve to bind above the tempestuous bay. On wings of cloth and wooden twine, he lay on the altar to open the way. Okay. From the song could be this very bay. What sort of wings are made of cloth and wood? Paraglider. Take care, may the light illuminate your path. Okay. Alright. So yeah, there's a powerful wind here. This can take me up. Maybe. Oh, I guess that's as high as I can go with it. Alright. Looks like that's a bombable wall. So I'm gonna pull out bomb arrows. I am in the wrong menu. I wish it weren't raining. Frickin' frick. Give me that bomb arrow. Fiddlesticks. Okay. I'm just gonna wait out the rain because it looks like I need bomb arrows for this. So I guess I'll see you when the rain stops. Okay, so it stopped raining. It's still windy as all hell, but you know. That's not surprising. Okay. Yeah. So I do want to say that I was here before and there was a rock thing that, a bombable rock wall right here, that you could bomb. And I had done that previously, so, yeah. Just something to note. So... Okay, well, that didn't do much. Maybe that's not what has nothing to do with it. I do want to climb to the top here, because there were some rocks, and I thought maybe there might be a Korok in there. Bombable rock wall formation over there. And right there as well. Okay. Beautiful. Okay. Oh, the more it is, the further it blows. Okay. Was that it? No. Do I have to bomb this other wall there? Okay, so there wasn't a Korok under the rocks, so I'm going to sail out over here. Bomb that wall. And that didn't look like it did anything. Other than, I guess, it gave me a way over here? Okay. Well, here's hoping. Still getting blown, so that's a good sign. That's it? Sweet. Well, that's cool. Alright, now we got another shrine to go into. So this'll probably just be rupees or something. It'd be nice to be something a little bit more, I don't know, useful. I don't really have any reason to have rupees other than to buy arrows, and that's like, okay, sure. Master of the Wind, complete. Sweet. Shai Yota, Yota, not Yoto, Yota, Shai Yota Shrine. Alright, inside we go. Yeah, yo, Shai Yota, how are you? What do you have for me? A great flame blade. Okay, cool. Alright, sweet. And I get one more orb. I need to go get a heart container. So I think that's how, well, I don't know. I guess I'll do that between episodes. It's still blowing it like hell, but I guess that's okay. Alright, so I can delete this stamp. Still not sure what this quest is all about. You know what? I'm gonna look it up. This has already been running long, but I'm just gonna look it up and do it, and yeah, I guess we'll end the episode with that. I can't think of anything else to do. There might be another memory or two, but who knows? I'm going to delete this because I don't need to kill that rock guy. Oh, I got this shrine to do still in these zones. I guess I'll look up this quest, do this one, and then do this shrine. We'll make this a longer episode, so I'll see y'all in a bit. Alright, so we're back here, and it turns out I was essentially right. I need to sneak up and mount a stag, and yeah, that's, and then ride him over there. So that's kind of what I was thinking. So I was right the first time, and I'm kind of happy about that. First I gotta find one. Oop, there. Ah, he despawned. What? I thought he was over here last time. Crap. Oh wait, no, there's one. So I went and bought the Sheikah stuff, the stealth stuff, to help with this. So, let's eat this. No, you don't see me. I should come up from behind him if possible, because I'm sure that's why he saw me so fast the last time. It looks like he's looking in my direction. Please don't see me here. Please don't see me here. Okay. So the instant he runs away, I'm gonna lose him. Like, he'll end up despawning or something. Carefully sneaking up on him. No, you don't see me. You don't see me. There we go. L, soothe. Nice. All right. Sweet. All right, let's move on out. Well, this is weird. But I'll just keep soothing him on the way over there. I guess he can't go any faster, which is fine. Alright. There we go. I'm still really happy that I had actually figured it out on my own and that I was just too lazy to actually try it myself. I'm like the fire thing. So, like, sometimes you just need to trust your intuitions occasionally. You gotta at least try it. So, alright. Thank you, fine stag. Run into the whatevers. I've got a reward to pick up. Alright. Mezzalo Shrine. Mezzalo. Doesn't matter. In we go. I said examine. Oh. Ancient Trifecta. This actually has a trial. I guess it makes sense. I mean, the quest itself wasn't super complicated. Let's see. What's hitting this thing do? It moved that. Okay. Ooh. Okay. Okay. All right. What happens if I throw a bomb over there? Detonate it. All right. Give me the chest. I guess I could have. Yeah, that's a metallic one. I could have just used magnesis. Ooh, a thunderblade. Sweet. Alright. Hit it again. That opens that. Now, the question is, do I have to stay standing on it? Yes. Okay. Magnesis. Get over here. Up and over here and drop that. Although apparently 10 apples will do the trick. Do I have 10 apples? 10 apples. I have 41. So. Let's see. Put that right about there. Alright, so how would I make sure they all stay on it? Whoops, that's not what I want to do. Okay. Drop. Whoops, that's not what I want to do. Okay. Let's see. Hold. Drop. Alright, hold. Drop. Beautiful. Awesome. Okay. Alright, so I'm hoping that this is gonna work. That moves that. Nope, not quite close enough. But, okay. I should be able to make it with my glider over there. Keyword being should. Alright. Easily. Come on, grab on, dang it. Alright. That should be good. Handily. Beautiful. Alright. Gimme dat orb. Gimme dat orb. Some kind of accent that I accidentally did, then I intentionally did for, and it didn't sound anything like the accent I was going for. Whatever that accent was. Alright. That was that one. And now, the last one. Last thing remaining to do is cast Qeta Shine. So let's go do that. Here we are. A major test of strength. Oh boy. Okay. What is this going to entail exactly? It's like make my defense go up. Let's make my speed go up. Oh wait, right, you can only use one at a time. Shit. Well, that wasted a defense up. Please don't be like a major guardian, a regular sized guardian. No, okay. It's one of these small guys. Holy, okay. Okay, well, that was interesting. Yeah, nope. Whoops, wrong way. Well, that hurt. Oh, God. Oh, come on, really? I deflected the one. Why didn't it go straight back? Wow, this is so dumb. Why is this so hot? Why does he have so much health? Holy crap. At least I got my stuff back, but god damn, what the hell is this shit? This is so dumb. Alright, let's go as the Twilight Princess Link. See, it probably doesn't do anything, but my god, this is dumb. I might just edit these fights out, because this is boring. There we go. God damn. Give me all these super fucking awesome weapons. I can't carry anymore? Well, I'm making fucking room for these things. Jesus, man. That was incredibly stupid. Okay. Weapons. Whee! Drop. Ancient Battle Axe +++. Guardian Sword +++. And I picked up the damn arm. I don't want that shit. Holy hell. That was a way to end, I guess. My god. That's insane. This better be good. Oh, climbing chest piece. Nice. I have the full climbing set now. That's cool. Twilight Princess Link came through for me, I guess. Let's see. Let's go with the Great Flame Blade, because that's the last one I'd been using, and it's damaged, so give me my well-earned orb, dude. I think I'm at, this will be 7, maybe 8, I don't know. I now have 7 orbs. Sweet. What? Oh. Let's see, I don't have a Korok leaf. Alright, well, I'm not gonna worry about that. Yeah, this was a longer episode, but I wanted to get things cleared up. One, for the live stream tomorrow, which will have been yesterday by the time this episode goes out, I hope. If not, well then, I guess I'll just see y'all in the next episode where I probably explore this area over here. Or maybe this one. I don't know. I still haven't decided yet. So, if you enjoyed this video, give it a like. If you didn't like it, give it a dislike. I would prefer if you leave a comment and let me know why you gave it such a ranking. I always look to improve this stuff. If you haven't subscribed to the channel, it's on the top right. If you want to see other Zelda stuff, I've played Twilight Princess. I've also played Wind Waker. There's other stuff on the channel. Go check all that stuff out. And I hope to see y'all in the next video.